Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing. Dead. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting closer.
They're watching.
They're watching. They're watching. They're watching.
This is a journey deep into darkness. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Can you see them?
You see it too.
You promised you can.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Turn back. Go back. Go back. It's not safe.
Look around and you'll see them. The drowned, the sick, the slain. Here they lie, rotting in the fields and rivers of hell. But the dead don't always lie still here. What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Senua's fear runs far, far deeper.
What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind?
I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Focus. Look closer.
Look.
Use your eyes.
Why isn't she looking closer?
She needs to look closer.
Focus.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate. Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of life, across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim. There's no doubt about
it.
The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there.
Hela.
her dear beloved. Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this? Why doesn't she turn around? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
He's dead.
But his soul is in Helheim.
His soul still lives. She needs to save his soul.
She wants his soul to be at peace.
She needs to lay him to rest.
He's already dead. She can save him.
There's nothing she can do. She thinks she's going to save him. She's not going to save him.
She'll never make it to Helheim.
She can't let him rot here.
Do you know where
you
are?
The bridge to Helheim.
Where are we?
I forget its name. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
The Northmen speak of 9 worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
You don't know where you're going. Get down.
What's she waiting for?
Get down. It's so brave.
Why did she do that? She should have done it.
Stop.
She can't go back now. No, this is it. The hidden path. Stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
Look really clearly.
I can see one.
Focus, hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate. towards the gate. And the gate opens.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
It worked.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She was trying to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. What good is that? We are always here. I guess it's the same with heights. You can stand on the edge, pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. Just wish things away.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed, and with her you must bargain.
The living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him.
Stop it.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop
Vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not my way.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Zurt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian.
To his soul. It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't she open it? She needs to challenge the gods.
She has